So you just bought a Trezor hardware wallet, you got it all set up, and now you want to safely store and secure all of your NFTs within that Trezor hardware wallet. Well, I have some good news and some bad news for you. You can store your NFTs within your Trezor wallet, but there are some limitations that you need to be aware of before sending them over. In this video, I'll be discussing all the drawbacks of storing your NFTs within your Trezor hardware wallet, and I'll be showing you how to send Ethereum and Polygon NFTs into your Trezor wallet. And I know a lot of people have been having issues dealing with Trezor and Polygon NFTs, like Brian Lai, who has been commenting on one of my videos. So by the end of this video, you'll know what works, what doesn't, and what you need to do moving forward. I'm Devrin Cook. Let's talk about Trezor, and welcome back to DevMoney. So first off, does Trezor actually support NFTs? And if you look at this online, you're gonna find some conflicting information. Well, the short answer is yes, you can store your NFTs within your Trezor. But if you look online and you read on Reddit, you're probably gonna see across the internet some official accounts from Trezor saying that they don't support NFTs. They don't support ERC-21 tokens. So how come Trezor themselves are saying throughout the internet and on Reddit that they don't support ERC-721 tokens, but they actually do support them on the Trezor wallet? Well, the difference really has to do with the Trezor wallet itself and the Trezor Suite software. Because the Trezor software suite that you get when you use Trezor wallet doesn't support NFTs. If you go and put NFTs on your Trezor wallet and then you go look in the Trezor suite, you're not gonna see your NFTs show up there. You're gonna have to use another interface like MetaMask in order to see them there. So to summarize, you can send your NFTs into your Trezor wallet, but when you go to Trezor Suite, you won't see them there. You're gonna have to use OpenSea or MetaMask to see your NFTs. Or you can check them out on Etherscan and see that they actually are in the address that you sent them to, which is connected to your Trezor. Hope that all makes sense. Let me know down below if you have any questions. Now, another thing you need to be aware of before using Trezor for your NFTs is that Trezor doesn't really support Polygon NFTs. From my understanding, and I don't pretend to be some technical genius, so if I'm wrong here, let me know in the comments. But from my understanding, Polygon NFTs use the EIP-712 protocol, and Trezor does not currently support this EIP-712 protocol. And that causes a lot of issues when trying to use the Polygon NFTs with Trezor. And you can still store these Polygon NFTs within Trezor. I'll show you how to do that here in a moment. But the issue comes when you're trying to get them back out, which I'll show you here later on as well. And in the future, Trezor is saying that the Model T is going to support EIP-712, which means that you'll be able to use Polygon NFTs with your Trezor. But that shouldn't be for about another week that we get that update on December 8th. Also, if you do have a Trezor Model 1 like I do, this little guy right here, you're not going to get that update. And so you won't be able to use Polygon NFTs with the Trezor Model 1. So you can see here on these forums that Pavel Rusnak is a co-founder of Trezor from Satoshi Labs right here. And you can see on this forum that he was having some dialogue with people about EIP-712 and whether it would be supported by Trezor Model 1. And he said that the firmware for Trezor Model T with EIP-712 support will be officially released in a few days, the 8th of December. And then someone asked, to be clear and be honest to us T1 users, Trezor Model 1, are you suggesting that we will not receive this update? And Prusnak said, I'm suggesting to you that you get the Trezor Model T if you need to use EIP-712 right now. Everything else is speculation. And a lot of people were having issues with that because a lot of people use the Trezor Model 1. It's much cheaper than the Trezor Model T, and people felt like he was just pushing everyone to buy a Trezor Model T so that they could make more money. And so he said, thank you for the valuable feedback. We'll discuss this internally. In the meantime, I am suggesting everyone getting a Trezor Model T if you need to use EIP-712 now. So if you do need to use Polygon NFTs with your Trezor and you have a Trezor Model 1, you're probably going to need to upgrade and get the Trezor Model T, or you're gonna have to use a different solution, which I'll discuss at the end of this video. So now let's send some NFTs to your Trezor wallet, and you're gonna see exactly how this works in action and where all the shortcomings are. All right, now before we can send NFTs into our Trezor, we first have to set up our Trezor with MetaMask. And so to do that is pretty simple, but there are some little tweaks you're gonna need to do on Trezor Suite in order to make this work. So what you're gonna do is first just plug your Trezor into your computer. And just so you're aware, this works for the Trezor Model 1 as well as the Trezor Model T. The steps are the same. So first thing you'll need to do is launch the Trezor Suite on your computer, and then once you've connected your Trezor to your computer, it's going to open up and you're going to be able to put in your PIN code. And you're going to see this little screen on your Trezor, and then you just put in your PIN code on your computer. Now, right now, I just have a standard wallet connected. So you're just going to launch your wallet. You're going to see that you need to confirm this action on your Trezor, and then it's going to open up your wallet and all of your preferences, and you can see all of your information here. You can see that I really have nothing in this wallet right now. So the next step is you're going to go onto your computer and you're going to open up MetaMask. You're going to log in by typing in your password, and then you're going to come up here to this little button right here. here and you're gonna hit Connect Hardware Wallet. Now you're gonna see this window, there's three different options, Ledger, Trezor, and Lattice, which Lattices are pretty nice. I have a Ledger, they're great as well, but we're gonna hit Trezor. So hit Trezor right here, plug in your Trezor wallet, which it already is, and hit Continue. Now you're gonna see this little loading button and you're gonna see that it wants to read the public keys from the Trezor device. That's totally fine. It's reading only the public keys and not the private keys, which is why we have a hardware device. Hit Allow once for this session, export public key of Ethereum account number one, hit Export, and now we're gonna need to type in our Trezor passphrase. So you're just typing that in here. Hit Enter once you've done, and then follow those instructions on your Trezor, and you're just gonna hit Confirm and confirm your passphrase. Now you're gonna see this window pop up with a bunch of different wallet addresses that you can choose from. Now this is gonna be a lot easier if you have money already, some Ethereum in the account that you're trying to connect to MetaMask, because then the account with the most money will pop up first and you'll know that that's the right account. But in this instance, since I don't have any money in this account, we're gonna need to come back here into Trezor Suite. We're gonna need to come down here to Ether and we're gonna hit Receive. And then we're gonna wanna see this full address. And this is gonna give us the address right here, and we wanna check this address against the ones that MetaMask are giving us. And we can see that it's 0xEB ending with A38. And then we come into here and we can see that that is not on this list of addresses, which is really frustrating. And if you scroll through so many of these, like I've done many, many times, you're gonna see that it still doesn't pop up. You really cannot find that address. And it can be really frustrating for a lot of people. So I'll show you how to fix that. The problem is you're using the wrong address on your Trezor suite. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna come back onto Trezor and you're gonna click out of this window and you're gonna come over here to your settings. You're gonna hit device and then you're gonna scroll down and you wanna make sure that you have this passphrase button enabled, because this is gonna allow you to create a hidden account within Trezor suite with a passphrase. So now that this is enabled, you're gonna come back to your dashboard and you're gonna scroll down here to this little button right here and it says add a hidden wallet. So you click on that right here and just add a passphrase for this hidden wallet. It's basically making you another set of accounts for Bitcoin, for Dogecoin, for Ethereum, at least in my case, because those are the accounts I have opened already. So go ahead and create a passphrase and then you're just gonna follow the instructions on your Trezor. It basically wants you to confirm this action, confirm the passphrase, and then you're good to go. It's gonna check the balances and then it's gonna show you this window right here. And in my case, since the wallet is empty, it just wants to make sure that I do want to open this empty wallet. So hit yes, enter the passphrase again, and hit confirm passphrase. Then one more time again, you gotta confirm on your Trezor, confirm the passphrase, and now you're good to go. And then you're gonna see if you come up here to the top left, you're gonna see that now you have a standard wallet with three accounts, and now you have a passphrase account with three accounts. And this is the one I wanna be in. Since it is my hidden account, I already labeled it MetaMask. So we wanna be in here, and now we wanna come in here to Ethereum. And again, we hit receive Ethereum. Show full address, and now we're gonna see this different address right here. It's gonna be 0xF2F ending with 816. And now when we come back here, we can see that this is 0xF2 ending with 816, and you can come over here to Etherscan if you wanna check the full address, but I know this is the right one. So you're gonna check this box and hit unlock. And now you can see here on MetaMask that you now have your Trezor account connected to MetaMask. And if you click on this little button right here, you're gonna see that this is a Trezor One account. You can rename it to anything you want, and that it is a hardware account. And this means that you have the added security of never having your private keys shared with the internet, because they're always staying on this hardware device. And so now if you come over here to OpenSea, you can see your account right here. And I wanna show you that you can store NFTs within this Trezor device by creating some dummy NFTs real quick. To do that, we're just gonna come up here to create. And then I have some images that we're just gonna drag over here. You can see I've got this tweet from Elon Musk right here. I'm gonna just name this Elon Tweet. And then we're gonna leave this on the Ethereum blockchain and hit create. Woohoo, you just created an NFT. Now I'm gonna create another one actually, and we're gonna go just drag another image down here. We're gonna hit Elon Tweet Polygon. Or I'm just gonna name it Elon Polygon. Now we're gonna change this to the Polygon network and hit create. Now we've just created these two NFTs, and you're gonna need to wait about a minute or so for these to show up in OpenSea. And if you do go into your MetaMask, you're gonna see that no matter how long you wait, that these don't show up. If you look in activity, they're not gonna show up. If you look under assets, they're still not gonna show up. And that is just because MetaMask doesn't natively show NFTs on their desktop app. You can see them in the mobile app, but you're not gonna wanna use the mobile app with your hardware device, because you'll have to put in your seed phrase. And then once you've waited about a minute and you go back into your OpenSea, you can see that the two NFTs are in your Trezor device that is connected here to OpenSea. And you can see both of these down here, this one that is on Polygon and this one that is just on Ethereum. So this shows that you can store both of these NFTs within your Trezor device. The issues come when you're trying to send them out of your device, at least for the Polygon NFTs. And just like you can create NFTs and store them within Trezor, you can send them to this Trezor as well. All you're gonna wanna do is copy this address right here and then go into your other account that has an NFT that you want to send to your Trezor. So all you're going to do is you're going to go into your other account, grab your NFT. This one is on standard Ethereum. Hit these three little buttons right here and hit transfer. You're going to hit this transfer button right here and you're going to paste the address that you want to send it to, the Trezor address, and then hit transfer. And then you'll get this notification pop up on MetaMask to confirm the transaction and send the NFT to your new address. And so that will allow you to send NFTs into your Trezor account on Ethereum, and to send Ethereum NFTs out of your Trezor device, you're gonna follow those same steps. You're just gonna have to confirm on your Trezor. So you're gonna come down to this NFT that's on a Trezor device on Ethereum, hit these three little buttons, hit transfer again right here, and you're gonna paste the address that you wanna send it to. And then once you hit transfer, you'll get the same notification pop up in MetaMask, and you're gonna need to hit confirm. I don't have any funds in this Trezor device right now, so I won't be able to send it out, but you're gonna hit confirm on MetaMask, and then you're gonna see it pop up on your Trezor. And then once you confirm on your Trezor, it's gonna send it out to that new address. And so Ethereum NFTs on Trezor work pretty much fine. They work all the time. You can send NFTs into and out of your Trezor device, no problem. But the issue comes when you're using Polygon, because if you come down here and try and send this NFT that is on Polygon into our Trezor device, you can see that it will work, but the issue is getting it back out. Because if we click these little buttons again, we can type in our Trezor device and hit transfer, see these wallet instructions and hit sign. You're gonna get this transfer processing page and then it's gonna say complete, and then you'll be able to go into your Trezor and see that this NFT has been transferred over. So when you switch over your account and look on OpenSea, you can see in your Trezor wallet the Ethereum NFT that was sent over and this other Polygon NFT that was sent over right here. So that's all well and fine that we got it into our Trezor device, but the issue is getting it out of our Trezor device. Ethereum ones work just great, but getting Polygon NFTs out is kind of tough and in some cases almost impossible, because we're in our Trezor wallet, and if we come over here to more options, hit transfer, type in our address that we want to send it to, and we're basically going to get this window right here that says you need to complete the steps, hit transfer. We're going to get this notification on our MetaMask, which is fine, we want this, but when you hit sign, you're going to get this window right here that says you declined the action in your wallet. This is not what we want to get, but this is happening all the time. And so we can try it again, we can transfer it again, hit sign, and this time nothing happened, we didn't even get that error message. And you can kind of just go around in this process over and over, as you can see, where you just keep hitting sign, keep hitting transfer, and nothing is really happening. And this again comes from the problem that Trezor does not support EIP-712, which means that Polygon NFTs will not be able to be sent out of the device, because MetaMask and Trezor are not communicating and they're not able to send the sign message over to the Trezor device so you can confirm it and actually carry out the transaction. So if you're looking to store your NFTs within Trezor, you're fine using Ethereum NFTs. It works great and you won't have any problems, or at least you should have minimal problems. I'm not gonna say there's gonna be none, because all of these hardware devices still have a couple of little glitches and little bugs that gotta be worked out. But Ethereum works great. Polygon, on the other hand, you're gonna have a hard time getting them out of your Trezor device. So how do you fix this? How do you get your Polygon NFTs off of your Trezor, especially if you actually paid money for these Polygon NFTs and you wanna get them out and resell them? So you're gonna have two options to get your Polygon NFTs out of your Trezor. Number one, you can take your seed phrase from your Trezor and use that to open a new MetaMask account. You're gonna go to MetaMask and you're gonna open a new account and import that seed phrase in there. And then since that MetaMask isn't interfacing with your Trezor, but it's using your seed phrase, you should be able to send out those NFTs into another device or to list them on OpenSea or whatever you wanna do with them. And the second option, which is definitely more secure, but is gonna cost you some money, is you're gonna need to buy a Ledger Nano, either the Ledger Nano S or the Ledger Nano X, which I have the X and I highly recommend it. And essentially you're gonna do the same thing, but this time with your new Ledger. You're gonna take that seed phrase from your Trezor and then use that to set up your Ledger. And once you've set up your Ledger with that seed phrase, you should have access to all of those NFTs and all of that crypto within your Trezor, except now they're stored and secured within your Ledger Nano X or Ledger Nano S. And I know you may be thinking,
well, if it didn't work on Trezor hardware wallet, why would it work on Ledger hardware wallet?
Well, this works actually because Polygon NFTs are supported on your Ledger device, as I've shown in multiple videos. So if you have a bunch of Polygon NFTs stored on your Trezor and you want to get them off of there, but you want to get them on another hardware wallet, this is going to be the best route for you to go. I use Ledger on a daily basis, not because it's perfect and not because I haven't had any issues, but because I do find that it's a better product, in my opinion, than the Trezor. So check the links down below in the description if you want to check out a Trezor or a Ledger hardware wallet. Let me know in the comments what questions you have. Thanks for watching. Check out this video right here, and I'll see you in the next video.